Billie Eilish reveals what it takes to pour your soul out on every record with her new documentary, The World's a Little Blurry.
Every single person in there, you know, is going through something good or bad or horrible or amazing, you know? The least I can do is make art that I make because I have the same problems.
With millions of listeners each month and a sold-out world tour cut short by the pandemic, you could say the 19-year-old sensation has fans, but she sees it differently.
I don't think of them as fans, ever. They're not my fans, they're like part of me.
The World's a Little Blurry releases in the wake of Framing Britney, an intimate look into the experience of growing up in front of the world. Being a global phenomenon is a great deal of pressure, an experience that Billie speaks openly about, but she does it by channeling the strength of her supporters.
Are you guys okay? Hey, you guys need to be fucking okay, because y'all are the reason I'm okay, okay?
Billie first captured her audience at the age of 13 when she released her debut track, Ocean Eyes. In 2019, she dropped her first album, When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go, that immediately connected with her supporters.
Don't you know too much already? I'll only hurt you if you let me.
Working with her brother and co-producer Phineas, When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go allows an intimate peek into her mind.
This is a self-portrait. This is some dick, some weird doll. This is a foot. There's some drips, and you can decide whatever the drips are. There's a bitch. There's a hairy vagina. There's a dick.
Ranging from soft ballads like the aforementioned When the Party's Over to heavy cuts like You Should See Me in a Crown shows the breadth of her creative drive.
Cold in my kingdom size, fell for these ocean eyes. You should see me in a crown.
Often Billie's most vulnerable and sincere thoughts get turned into heart-wrenching music.
Step on the glass, staple your tongue, bury a friend, try to wake up, cannibal class, killing the sun, bury a friend, I wanna end me.
This song is the reason I don't. Like, having this way of saying it instead of doing it is better.
Billie's openness and honesty is what closes the gap between her and her listeners and invites them to join on her journey.
So dark, like, have happy music. I'm like, what? I'm never feeling happy, so why would I write about things I don't know about? You know, I feel the dark things. I feel them very strongly.
And although critics categorize her material as dark, her mother disputes the way the world receives Billie's music.
People are like, oh, you know, Billie Eilish's music is depressing. It's like, no, kids are depressed.
But she also offers that fun-spirited nature of a young woman on tracks like Bad Guy and All the Good Girls Go to Hell.
My turn to ignore ya. Don't say I didn't warn ya. All the good girls go to hell. 'Cause even God herself has enemies.
Presenting herself in such a candid way gives her supporters the opportunity to do the same, and she takes that responsibility very seriously.
Being able to say something and be heard, I try to take that in as much as possible.
I never decided to. I never was like, I'm gonna talk about this, and I'm gonna talk about this. Mm. I just talked about what I was feeling. And now that I think about it, like, I realize how many people aren't talking about that kind of stuff and why people are so, like, shocked when you do talk about it. I'm like, yeah. Why is that so shocking? Like, I'm telling you, like, about how I am as a human. Like, why is that weird?
And that vulnerability is met by endless support from the people she calls family. I'm Delisa with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music.